our previous video, we saw the fundamentals of performance testing. We also saw what is performance testing and why do we conduct performance testing and how do we conduct performance testing. If you have missed the video, please click the link on the description. Also, I request everyone to like, share the video and subscribe to the channel. Today in this video, we are going to see about the types of performance testing and what is load testing and how do we do it. Welcome to Little Sloth, and this is me, your Vasant Shanmugam, presenting you this video on load testing. There are various types of performance testing, and some of them are load testing, stress testing, volume testing, soak testing, and scalability testing. Today we are going to see about what is load testing, why are we doing load testing, and what are the outcomes of load testing, and how do we do load testing. First, let's start with what is load testing. Load testing helps to determine the behavior of an application when large numbers of users access the application simultaneously. Load testing is a type of performance testing which identifies the maximum operating capacity of an application. Load testing helps to know whether the existing infrastructure is capable to run the application or not. Load testing is conducted to determine the number of concurrent users that an application can support without deterioration in performance. This load testing is usually performed for client-server and web-based application. Let's see an example for load testing. We create a load test script and configure it with 1000 virtual users and run it for 1 hour duration. After the load test gets completed, we analyze the test result to determine how the application will behave at the expected peak load. Okay, so now we have successfully completed the load testing, and let's now see what are the output of load testing or what can we infer out of load testing results. We can collect the response time of each transaction of the application that are involved in the load testing. We can identify the performance of the application under different load conditions of system components. We can also identify the performance of the application under different load conditions of database components. We observe the network delays between the client request and server response. We can narrow down to the issues in software design. We can also list down the limitations due to hardware like CPU maximization, network bottleneck, memory limitation, etc. Apart from hardware bottlenecks, we can also list down the issue in software configuration such as web server, application server, database server, etc. So far we saw the outcomes of load testing. Now we will see few advantages of doing load testing. The first advantage is improved scalability. Load testing helps to identify the number of users the application can support in production or in live environment. The load test also helps in determining the need for additional infrastructure in case there is a demand for scaling the application. Next, we will see about downtime. Downtime is always a pain area for both the customers and the business. So let us now see about how the load testing helps in reducing the system downtime. Load testing gives a better picture of an application's limitation when it goes live. The solution to high volume traffic problem can be made beforehand, which reduces the system downtime considerably. The next advantage is too crucial because it actually increases revenue to the business, saves lots of money, and reduces cost due to the application failures. Reduction in cost due to failures. The failures during production can cause significant costs due to unavailability of application or any other such problem. With load testing, the defects can be prevented before they arise, reducing cost implications of failure. Now, the last and the most important advantage: improved customer satisfaction. With lesser number of system downtimes and ability to serve to a large number of users, the overall customer satisfaction with the application increases, which causes users to revisit the site more often. We as a user or a customers, we basically go back or visit a website only if it satisfies us and if it exceeds our expectations. So in the way, load test helps us to get an application that performs well. Let's now move to how to do load testing step by step. There are various tools available in the market to do load testing, which we will discuss in our upcoming videos. So please subscribe to the channel and don't miss the videos. Okay, let's now move to the first step of load test. The first step involves creating a dedicated test environment for load testing. The next step includes determining the load test scenarios, and basically it is identifying the business critical transactions. Next, we determine the load testing transactions for the application that include preparing test data for each transaction, predicting the number of users accessing the application, determining the connection speeds, determining the different browsers and operating systems on the user's end, configuring web, application and DB servers. So once we identify all the transactions and other factors, now we move to executing the test scenario and monitoring the results by collecting various metrics. At the end of the testing, we do analyzing the results for making recommendations. If in case we find any bottleneck during analysis, we do the tuning of the system or we suggest the same to the concerned team and retest the application. Now we are towards the end of the video. So to summarize the points on load testing, load testing is a critical part of the software testing process as it ensures that the software performs to render high user satisfaction. A successful load testing will help to release high quality software. Thanks everyone for watching. Please do subscribe the channel. Thank you.